I don't know how to explain this shape, but just try to replicate what I'm doing there. I can't really describe what the shape is. And here's a close-up of that. The next thing I'm doing here is just drawing the gum part of the lip. Try to space out these little like triangles evenly. Now I'm drawing little lines to separate each tooth. Try to replicate that shape of the teeth. It's very important to keep to that shape. Now I'm just drawing the outer part of the lip. This part doesn't really have to be perfect. I've seen a lot of different versions of the same drawing, and I feel like every single outer lip is different, so this part really does not have to be perfect. I know I said I was going to try and make this tutorial as easy as possible and try to explain everything step by step, but I mean, to be fair, there's not really a way to explain these shapes. You have to look at what I'm doing, I guess. But yeah, it doesn't have to be perfect as long as you've got like a basic shape that looks like this so far. Then I'm just drawing the little segments. With these segments, you really do not have to be precise. It doesn't really show up in the final drawing, so you can just basically draw any like little triangles that fit together. There doesn't have to be a specific amount of them, just needs to be a general shape of a line. I drew 6 here, but it doesn't matter how many you draw. This part isn't really going to show up in the final drawing, but it does give you a rough idea of what it's supposed to look like. Now I'm going to be using a kneaded eraser just to go over the drawing to make the lead a lot lighter, and so it's easy to go over with color pencil. Now I'm going to be using a black pencil. Try to keep all your pencils as sharp as possible. It really does help with blending, and it does help with just overall making the drawing look better. Now I'm just going to be going around the line with this black pencil as sort of like a shadow, because it will affect. I'm not really going over the part of the line where the teeth touch, as in the reference it does look like there's more green in that shadow than black. Now I'm just drawing the shadows inside the mouth, just the small things around the teeth. So this is how it should look. This part is a little bit unfocused. What I am doing now is just going around the lip with a bit of shadowing. Now I'm just using a white pencil to go over the areas that have the most highlights. I'm not doing the teeth right now because I'm going to focus on that separately. But yeah, just for the lips, the places that have the most highlights is where you should put the white pencil. Don't press too hard once again, because we are going to be adding more color over that. Now I'm going to be going around the lime a bit with this white pencil. As you can see, there is quite a lot of white around these areas, so I just went in with the white. And I colored in the seeds lightly with the white pencil. This is how it should look. So now I'm just going lightly around the lips with light green. Do not press too hard in this step. I'm just going over the whole thing, including the white parts, the black parts, everything. I just went over the bottom lip with a couple of layers of lime. And now I'm just going in onto the highlighted areas with a bit of yellow to really bring out those highlights. Once again, don't press too hard when it comes to these steps. Just lightly go over the area with the color pencil. Now I'm going to be using a dark green. This is going to go all over the darker shadows. Try not to go over the highlighted places with dark green, as we should try to keep them as light as possible. Now the picture's really starting to come together. Now we can basically see what's going on and how things are going. I saw a bit of a shadow around the top of the top lip, and I decided to just go over with a bit of dark green in those areas. I'm just zooming in a bit so you can see more of what I'm doing here. Okay, now I'm just going over with the dark green in the darker areas again, pressing a little bit harder than I was before, just to really like create those shadows and just like make it a little bit more bold. Now I'm just filling in the inside of the mouth with black, and I'm going around the line for the more harsher shadows. Now with my lime green, I'm basically gonna go over the entire lip, pressing pretty hard on the paper. This is called burnishing, basically where you like blend the entire drawing with one pencil and pressing as hard as you can. Then I went over it a bit with the yellow to bring out the highlights a bit. Yeah, so that is the top lip done. Now I'm going to be doing the bottom lip. Same thing again, just press as hard as you can over the highlighted areas and a bit into the darker areas just to blend it out nicely. Now I'm just adding yellow to the bottom lip too, just to bring out the highlights a bit. Now with the gums, I wasn't really sure what color to do this, so I just went in with a bit of skin color and a bit of red and blended them together in hopes of seeing something somewhat like a gum color, I guess. Now I'm just pressing as hard as I can with my teeny tiny white pencil for the teeth, and I'm adding a bit of shadowing with my black color pencil. Now I'm just blending in the shadows that I added onto the teeth with my white pencil. I do switch between white pencils, but it is because one of my white pencils works better than the other one. But anyway, so now what I'm doing to the lime is just adding a bit of texture by drawing little scribbles in an inward direction to the center of the lime. This really does help add texture and does make it appear appear like a lime. So yeah, I'm just going over with a bit of white. Now I'm adding a bit of shadows with my dark green pencil, just as I did with the white, just a lot less. Adding some shadows around the seeds and in some of the areas inside the lime. Now I'm just going over the entire drawing with my lime color pencil, or my light green color pencil. Kind of pressing pretty hard in this part. I'm coloring over everything except the seeds because I want to keep the seeds white. And now I'm just going around the lime with my white because the outside of the lime is a little bit lighter than the inside. And I'm just going over it again with some white because I did realize that my lime was a little bit dark, and just coloring the seeds a little more. Now I'm just going over the outside of the lime to show a bit of dark green skin. Now I'm just going over the lips again with light green and doing some touch-ups a bit on the outside. As you can kind of tell, it doesn't really matter how much you go over the shadowed parts with the lime, it doesn't really do much, but with the highlights it really does bring out the highlighted parts. And this is how it looks so far. We're not done yet though. This is my favorite part of any drawing ever. I love this part in drawing, and that is adding highlights. I just added a bunch of white scribbles around the whole lime. What I do suggest is just going in one direction, just going inward to the center of the lime. And now I'm just adding a bit of highlights to the top of the lip. It doesn't really matter what shape your highlights are, it just needs to look a little bit like this. I added some dots there, and I added some lines to the side, and a few little scribbles on the bottom there to make it look more glossy, and some dots around the edges of the lime. And on the inside, on the teeth, this part's also pretty important because the teeth are also shiny, so yeah. And now the final part is to sign it. I signed it with my Instagram username, and yeah, that is it. We're done. We made it. We did the lime. Yeah, anyway.